sitting duck out there.
He knows what he's doing.
I am the law.
Wait a minute. That's not the movie we're reviewing. No! It's ISO Cubes for you! ISO Cubes!
Inhabitants of pinch trees, this is Judge Dredd. In case some people have forgotten, this block operates under the same rules as the rest of the city. Mama is not the law. I am the law.
That's more like it, citizen.
Mama is a common criminal. Any who obstruct me in carrying out my duty will be treated as an accessory to her crimes. You have been warned. And as for you, Mama, judgment time.
Citizen Hap, I sentence you to 5 months in ISO cubes for dissing a judge, eh?
Hold on, rookie. I am a judge. Just like you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
Oh, yeah? Well, now I'll sentence you to 10 months in ISO cubes for impersonating a judge, eh?
There's people watching.
I'll be the judge of that.
Yeah,
oh. Hey, everybody.
Hey.
Welcome to episode number 49 of the Doomgoryum Report, brought to you by Judge Happy Wax.
Judge Axe.
And this is... Jimmy's being judged.
Yeah.
Severely.
Jimmy the Viking.
In case you haven't noticed what this episode of the Doomgoryum Report is about, it's on a 2012 flick remake called Dredd. Mm. And it's a special request by our number one fan, a guy that goes by the name of... He doesn't go by the name of Chuck Norris. He goes by the name of Power Mad Headbanger. He requested this one.
So
this one's coming out to you, man. Dredd. And, yeah. So in the cast, we have... Well, first of all, it was directed by Martin Campbell. No, it wasn't. Why do I have Martin Campbell up here? There we go, because I'm looking at the wrong thing. My visor is blocking my vision. Okay, director
Stalin.
Director Pete Travis. And in the cast, as Dredd, of course, we have Carl Urban, who did an excellent job.
Oh.
We have Olivia Thirby as Cassandra Anderson, a.k.a. Rookie.
Beautiful.
We have Lena Headey as, I hope I pronounced that right, Headey.
Yep.
As Madeline Madrigal, a.k.a. Mama.
Awesome job.
And then we've got Wood Harris as Kay, and the other fella, Warwick Greer as Caleb. There you go. So, Dredd, the long-awaited review, 2012. You dragged me out to see this movie.
Yeah.
I was dreading going to see Dredd because I was thinking, I am the law.
I am the law.
The 19 whatever 90s, yep. Sylvester Stallone thing, and I was like, ugh.
Yeah.
I loved it. I was really happy. I went to see it.
Incendiary.
When I had the trailer and I showed the trailer, I made the call then. I said, this movie looks freaking awesome because it's how, for anyone who reads the comic book, I'm not a big comic book reader, but I mean, I go to the comic book shops once in a while. So yeah, I don't, you know, whatever, but you can tell Dredd is like a dirty, just kind of a Clint Eastwood,
An anti-hero kind of thing.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Just balls to the wall, kick your ass if you look at him the wrong way. And that's exactly how Carl Urban played this character.
On the piercing.
just say wait? You know what? I expected more of you. I mean, wait for what? Wait for me to change my mind? Wait for another 2 or 3 seconds of life because you're so fucking weak you just can't stand to see it end? No. Whoever heard of Shuchio?
I don't think he cracked a smile for the whole thing.
No.
He was nothing but serious. I mean, if you looked at him cross-eyed, he'd judge you and shoot you.
I can't do what he did with his face. Like, with his face, he's like...
Yeah, it's funny, yeah.
I was watching it again the other night, and I was thinking to myself, man, did that expression stay on the bottom half of his face when he was done? Because he was like...
They must have shot him up with cortisone or something.
I can't even do it, man. Like his chin was sticking out, and it was like...
It's so funny watching him play Dredd and then turning around and watching Star Trek and watching him play McCoy. Is this the same guy? You know what I mean? Like, yeah. he's an awesome actor. He really is. Like, I mean, he's had some pretty crappy movies, you know, like Doom and a few other low balls. But, I mean, he was great in The Lord of the Rings, and he was awesome in Dredd, and he was good in Star Trek. I mean, he's a great actor. And, I mean, when I saw the trailer, I loved it. But again, I was skeptical, like you said, going to see it, because really, if you given the past history of any movie that includes the 3D in the title, it wasn't just Dredd, it's Dredd 3D, you know what I mean? And if you include that, any movie pretty much sucks. And I thought, oh, this is going to be horrible, but I thought it was absolutely fantastic.
And on the side of the 3D, I mean, it was good to watch it again the other night in the dungeon, but basically... When you did see it in the movie, like with the whole idea of the slow-mo, the drug that slows everything down, it was perfectly made for that real D or 3D. And like right from sort of, you know, at first when we first sat and started watching it, the first opening chase scene, I was like, okay, like why is this a modern mega city with this guy riding this, you know, jet cycle and he's chasing a Volkswagen van? But after that, it was kind of like... Yep. Right from the scene where they blow the door open and everybody's stoned on the slow-mo, which slows everything down, and the guy's chest rippling, and like it was just, everything was awesome. Like it sucked you right in, and it was pretty cool.
Yeah, I don't really have anything bad. I've said to you many times, I've watched this movie probably 30 plus times since I bought it on Blu-ray. It's one of my nightly fall asleep to movies.
Yes.
So, it used to be The Dark Knight, but now Dredd's kind of taken over. So it's, I'm just surprised we haven't done a review on it sooner. But it's
been a busy time down there in the dungeon. Yeah. So,
but it was awesome. Even Lena Headey as Mama, I thought she did a fantastic job.
Yeah, like if you look at, I was looking her up for doing the review, and like she doesn't look anything. Like I didn't realize she was the one from Game of Thrones and everything else. Like she doesn't look, she looked mean too. I was wondering like if, you know, where'd they find this girl? Like I didn't know if it was her. So
it was awesome. And you know what else I really liked, and this is what hit home for me, was they didn't cop out and try and go the route of, oh, let's make all sorts of huge money by making it PG because it was rated R.
Yeah.
Not like the piece of shit that Sylvester Stallone put out.
Drop your weapon!
Where he's totally sold out, where everything's nice and clean and his suit's all shiny and it's PG and there's no blood and there's no sweat.
Yeah.
Like this is probably more how it would probably be in real life.
It reminded me of two things. It reminded me kind of The Punisher. And it reminded, like the Punisher with Thomas Jane, which was a killer movie. And Blade Runner. I couldn't get Blade Runner out of my head, you know, because of the sort of dark... futuristic sort of world, and I don't know, I thought it was an excellent flick.
What would we do without Ridley Scott?
I don't know.
He is an awesome director.
We'd have to become directors ourselves.
Yes, because he's awesome. How many movies have you watched where you think back, this has got Blade Runner-esque styles to it?
Well, it makes sense, right? Yeah. I mean, that's why, because it's his perception. But
I hope they make another one. I really do, because this one did pretty good, you know what I mean? Like, it made a lot of money. It made its budget back over here, but it really did well overseas, and then when it came out on DVD and Blu-ray, it made a killing. So I'm hoping that they'll make a sequel to it, and they keep all the same, you know, well, really, other than Carl Urban, Lena Headey, and I can't remember what Rookie's name is, but other than those three, it was pretty much a cast of who are these people, do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
So, I mean, as long as they can keep those two people, right, because obviously Mama's dead, but, you know what I mean, like, you know, that would be good, and I don't, it'd suck if they changed up the Carl Urban, you know, for somebody else, so hopefully he comes back for a sequel, because I think there's tons of room to expand on this.
Yeah, hopefully they don't come with, back with, like, Ben Affleck or something like that.
Okay.
Well, Matt Damon. Rookie. All right.
I'd have to give it a 9.5
yep.
me. So
yep.
Just for not saying the 10 for the full paw of giving it a 10, you know what I mean? So that's what I'd say.
Yeah, I definitely, yeah, 9.5. This movie, it was awesome. It was almost like a Battleship when we went to see it.
Yeah,
we thought it was
going
to blow chunks.
Yeah.
And we left going, holy Christ, was that ever a good movie.
It was an awesome movie,
Yeah, but this movie is fantastic. So if you haven't seen it, I mean, put it on the to-do list to get this one into your collection because it's pretty awesome.
Don't listen to us. You be the judge.
Yep.
Judge it yourself. If you don't see it, we'll put you in ISO cubes.
ISO cubes.
And you don't want to go there.
You've been judged.
They're almost as bad as tiger cages, but I don't want to talk about that.
Or even worse, death.
So, anyways, thanks for tuning in to Doomgoryum Report number 49, Dredd. Power Med Headbanger, thanks for the requests, and sorry for the time to get it out to you, but stay tuned for more. Stay tuned for, this weekend is the Walking Dead's final show for the season, so Dead Walk Talk should be rather interesting. We'll probably get Chat back in here. And
I think this is going to be my new look.
I like it.
So do I. It looks good on you. It looks good. He worked hard. He was up over 12 hours last night banging out these Dredd helmets.
I used to be in wardrobe.
Yeah.
So
I think you're going to see a lot of this. I like this look.
Oh, yeah. It's the new special effect department.
You
kind of
look like Carl Urban, too.
Can't do it.
Rookie.
All right. From the dungeon.
All right.
Stay scared.